Housing sales touch all-time high. This city sees biggest price jump. Witnessed 30% growth in sales over 47,000 units last year to 61,700 units this year. I'm talking about Hyderabad. This city, which dares to plan and execute a fast-paced infrastructure development, the latest being construction of the Jawaharlal Nehru Outer Ring Road, mirroring Beijing's 8 Bangles Ring Road, promises swift connectivity across the city, where green certifications like LEED and IGBC are order of the day and has emerged as one of India's fastest-growing and most prosperous metro cities. It's not just commercial success, but residential properties too. It has expanded to cover the entire Telangana region, poised to become a global hub of IT and, of course, manufacturing firms as well. I'm Kishan Milani, into the business of real estate for 32 years now. Friend, if you're new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. Also, I'm happy to inform you that we have started a new channel where we share short clips on the most interesting real estate topics. Kindly subscribe. Let us look at the reasons behind the real estate growth in Hyderabad. One, infrastructure development. The government has made several investments to improve the city's infrastructure, which has led to an increase in the number of people moving to the city, which in turn has increased the demand for housing. This initiative of the government, I have been personally witnessing for over 40 years now. And I remember one of the earlier governments, and at that time, Mr. Chandrababu Naidu was the chief minister of that time, it was Andhra Pradesh. The roads were widened and there were buildings chopped off. It gave way for wider roads and wider infrastructure within the city and outside the city. That is why Hyderabad is what it is today. When we talk about connectivity, Jawaharlal Nehru Outer Ring Road is getting improvements made to compete with Beijing's 8 Bangles Ring Road. This will help commute from the Rajiv Gandhi International Airport and to nearby cities like Vijayawada, Warangal, Nizamabad and Adilabad. And integration of the western and eastern parts of the city via the Blue Line Metro Rail project depicts the well-laid out plans for infrastructure development that have made it an attractive destination for businesses. These regions are home to the SEZs, industrial corridors and IT hubs. Thus, a resultant influx in need for more residential properties as people are looking for places to live near their work. The concept of walk to work is something which is being implemented in all the IT corridors throughout the country. The Hyderabad Regional Ring Road project has a proposal of 4-lane access control road connecting its neighborhood districts. This advancement in commuting capabilities will decrease the intra-city travel time along with generating employment and livelihood opportunities for the people outside of this area. Reason 2 is safe city and the best quality of life. People want to live in a clean and safe environment, and Hyderabad performs exceptionally well on these parameters. A recent report released by the UK-based Comparitech listed Hyderabad as one of the world's top 50 most surveillance cities of the world. This report shows how the CCTV cameras in Telangana's capital provide a better sense of security to the residents, deeming it very attractive for people to move in. Third, cost-effective properties. Hyderabad is a city with a lot of new development happening. This means that the best real estate developers in Hyderabad are building many new apartments and properties are available at relatively reasonable prices throughout the city. Gated community apartments, plots, etc. in the city are cheaper than in any other tier 1 city like Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, Chennai, Pune, etc. Friends, you must also know that all of South mostly has plotted development also, where people prefer to stay in plots in their own houses. Fourth reason is commercial hub. The city is home to many large businesses and industries. This has led to high demand for office spaces. So many new commercial buildings have been constructed here to meet this growing demand. Hyderabad is still affordable. That's the reason people who cannot afford Bangalore, Mumbai, Delhi NCR or Pune are settling in Hyderabad, because the infrastructure is very robust. Price point is pretty reasonable. So their business can sustain. And fifth is large IT companies. The presence of IT companies in Hyderabad is bringing people from all over the country as well as the world. That's why the demand for housing is increasing, and demand for plush houses or posh houses is also increasing. Hyderabad also has the distinction of having the best of pharmaceutical companies and biotechnological companies with world-class facilities. The city is becoming increasingly popular as a place to live and work, thanks to the presence and expansion of global giants such as Google, Apple, Microsoft, Deloitte, and hundreds of other blue-chip companies operate out of Hyderabad. By the way, we have been making several videos on where to invest. So we have made one on where to invest in Pune, where to invest in Mumbai, where to invest in Bangalore. We've got a playlist. In case you're interested, you can have a look at it. Where to invest in Hyderabad. Wherever this infrastructure is there, wherever this connectivity is there, go and shop for your dream house there. So Hyderabad's metro's phase 2 expansion is underway. They are also converting 52 significant junctions to a signal-free zone, which will transform city's traffic conditions. And subways and underpasses to be built in the significant junctions like Jubilee bus stand to Shamirpet, Turkapalli, Uppal, Ghatkesar, Paradise Junction, Kompalli, and other primary locations. Critical projects like Aerospace Park, the Gaming and Animation Park, the Smart and Data Center, Pharma City, and Life Sciences and Medical Device Park would definitely bring in a lot of employment in those locations, and these are the places you can watch for. Construction of Musi River Expressway for beautification and redevelopment projects that include riverfront development and pedestrian-friendly pathways. This is already happening in many other cities, including Pune. Here, I cannot forget Rajiv Gandhi International Airport, which is due for its expansion. We have made a video on top 10 airports of India, and Rajiv Gandhi International Airport does figure there. So if you want to check this out, I'm sharing the link in description. You can have a look at this. City's residential market is divided into 4 districts: Hyderabad, Medchal, Malkajgiri, Rangareddy, and Sangareddy. And home sizes from 500 to 1000 square feet did see a growth of about 18% last year, while home size from 1000 to 2000 square feet remained the highest with about 68% share. And coming to the statistics of where most homes were bought, so Medchal and Malkajgiri area had the highest home sales registration at 43%, followed by Rangareddy at 39%. Hyderabad district accounted for 15% of overall registrations. Sangareddy district experienced the most significant year-on-year increase of 9%, indicating higher value property sales in the area. Hyderabad's real estate landscape is continuously evolving with several emerging submarkets, which is garnering significant attention from Gachibowli, Kondapur, Nalagandla, Kokapet, Narsingi, and Telapur on the city's periphery have witnessed remarkable growth. The expansion of IT corridor towards these regions, coupled with improved connectivity throughout the outer ring road, has fueled their popularity. In addition, neighborhoods like Kompalli and Shamirpet in the northern part of Hyderabad are emerging as promising investment destinations. The availability of schools, education institutes, healthcare facilities, and improved infrastructure have played pivotal role in their growth. And the CBD of Hyderabad and Secunderabad, the twin city, is not different from any other city that we talk about. But you don't expect high capital appreciation in these locations. So Hyderabad has the best of them, like Begumpet, Bhuvanpalli, Trimalgiri, Himayatnagar, Bashirbagh, Khairtabad. The older side of city is Ambarpet, Dilsuknagar. So all these places are definitely worth being there, but they don't promise very high returns. And of course, the shoppers' locations are MG Road, Avids, and Charminar side. In addition to these, there are 5 top residential locations which are recommended for investment in real estate in Hyderabad. Number one is Gachibowli. It's dotted by several IT giants like Apple, Amazon, Accenture. Gachibowli is a thriving corporate hub. Home values in Gachibowli witnessed a humongous 100% appreciation in the last 5 years, averaging around 10,000 rupees per square feet. Number two would be Hi-Tech City. It's renowned for its prominent commercial hub. Hi-Tech City is the home to significant IT parks like Raja Mindspace, RMZ, Futura, Ascendas. It is strategically located near the key roads. The ORR is about 3 kilometers, easing connectivity to other commercial hubs such as the Financial District, which is a major development in that side of Hyderabad, and Kokapet. And with an average price of about 11,500 rupees per square feet, properties in Hi-Tech City have appreciated by about 90% in the last 5 years, which is significant. Third is Madhapur. Madhapur is a meticulously planned residential hub to address the increasing demand in the city. It is positioned as the premium locality in West Hyderabad. Madhapur is located close to NH-65, which ensures seamless interstate connectivity. Employment hubs like Hi-Tech City and Mindspace IT Park are within 5 kilometers of the locale. They significantly contribute to the residential demand. Further, Madhapur too is home to many IT companies like Signity Technologies, Paraminfo Solutions, and Landmark IT Solutions. What eases the travel across the city is the dedicated metro station on the blue line of the Hyderabad Metro, which connects Raidurg to Nagole. The property price in Madhapur averages around 11,000 rupees a square feet and has posted an impressive about 83% hike in the last 5 years. And the fourth is everybody's favorite, Jubilee Hills. It is home to Telugu Film City. Jubilee Hills is one of the most expensive residential and commercial areas in Hyderabad. It has several media companies, studios and residences of renowned film personalities, politicians and business tycoons. With regard to housing stock, Jubilee Hills offers a mix of apartments, plots and independent houses. The price ranges in the range of about 10 to 15,000 rupees a square feet. While Jubilee Hills houses many IT companies like Cognizant Technologies, Genpact and Infosys, among others, the technology hubs of Hightech City, Raja Mindspace and Phoenix Infocity within 7 km radius also contribute to its residential market. Sanjeeva Reddy Nagar, that is NH65, links Jubilee Hills to many places of commercial and recreational interest. Number 5, Banjara Hills, the very old and popular destination. Of course, this also has prominent high street retail hub of Hyderabad. The commercial landscape fuels the residential demand again. So about 1 km from NH65 and PV Narasimha Rao Expressway, Banjara Hills is well connected to other parts of the city. Also, Lakdiga Pool and Khairatabad MMTs are just 3 kilometers away. Major IT hubs close to Banjara Hills include International Tech Park, Mindspace, Kohinoor IT Park, and for shopping and recreation, GVK One Mall and Next Galleria Mall are the prime destinations. Banjara Hills, like I said, has been there for quite some time. So this is pre-IT era. Banjara Hills is pretty popular since then. That's the reason the prices have been rising gradually over a period of time. The appreciation over the last 5 years would be in the range of about 50 to 60%. So given the price appreciation, the above localities in Hyderabad have the potential for better returns. However, I suggest analyzing the price trends, consulting local experts and conducting site visits before finalizing any property. Like any other market, even this market has challenges and risks. One, regulatory changes can significantly impact the real estate landscape, such as changes in the land use regulations, zoning laws, or property taxes, which can either boost or hinder investment prospects. Second, market volatility. The city can experience fluctuations in property prices due to economic conditions, demand-supply imbalance, or global economic factors can affect the return of investment and the time it takes to realize profits. So friends, you got to consider all these aspects before you take a conscious call while buying real estate. I hope you like this video. Kindly like it, send us your comments and share it with your friends. Let me also know in comment section in case you have any different experience about buying property in Hyderabad or any different location that you have seen better appreciation. Thank you very much. Goodbye and take care of yourself.